I love it when a plan comes together. Ah, man, I love this game. All right, I clearly didn't play long. I just wanted to make sure that the game worked. But we gon' play. We gon' play. And hopefully not embarrass ourselves as poorly, well, as badly as we did with Super Mario World 2. I don't know. I didn't think it went that bad, but, you know, it was bad. It was bad. I just, you know, it's been a while. I've seen some incredible speedrun stuff in this game, and none of it's going to happen here. We're going super casual. Actually, I should mention that. I'll do that before anybody gets upset about my shitty play. Super casual. And then we die immediately because we're not paying attention. Super casual. At least it wasn't the first enemy in the game. Saw something on the internet about how that first Goomba has probably killed more people than any other enemy in the game, in any game. And that that may be true. What's up, Gonzo? We're just chilling, hopefully. I'm glad you streamed today. It's been a while. We'll stop by. Appreciate you stopping by, bro. Oh, Christ. I still have Facebook open. That's gotta go. Well, I'm hoping your new setup, ah, son of a bitch, turned out well. Because I know we were all looking forward to checking that out. Ha! Ha! Earlier than you thought. Yeah, I can't stream on, Thursday, or probably not Friday. I'm hoping I can stream on Friday, though. I love this shit. Missing the drill. Just found out today that my cat hasn't just learned how to climb into cabinets. He's actually been, like, chilling out there. Now I feel like I have to put something in there for him. Oh, good, man. I'm hoping that the webcam's in the right position for you, too. And now you can buy yourself a microphone boom. Get that damn table noise off. I think he's in the cabinet right now, too. I thought it was frozen. Oh. Yeah, he's definitely in there. I'm telling you, that Rode PSA-1, that's a hell of a boom. I'm glad I spent the $100. no. Do I have to... Oh, I have to give you up. Sorry, friend. Stay. Don't go too far. I'll be back. What's up, K-Wall? We're doing the retro thing. Right now, I feel like my whole childhood is coming back. Tanuganu! Que paso, man? Oh, yeah, yeah. I was, actually, after you mentioned that, I looked up to see if there were any Twitch events in Minnesota. No, nobody does anything. I should probably organize something. Did you make any business cards? Because I understand that's pretty big in the culture. Thinking about making some. Funny story about Super Mario games. My best friend in the world, we've been friends since, I think longer than anybody else I've been friends with, was playing Super Mario Brothers 3. She lived in New York at the time. And she and her friend got really drunk and decided that they were going to play Super Mario Brothers 3 one night. And man, I guess it took them forever because it was like a whole night. And I get this call at 2 or 3 o'clock in the morning, our time, which was, you know, way too late their time. And she's like desperate. She's asking me, Ron, how do I beat Bowser at the end of Super Mario Bros. 3? I'm like, I couldn't even think at the time. So I tell her how. And I was really pissed off about getting woken up that way. But then they did it, and like 2 minutes later, I got a phone call thanking me for my help. Anyway, she's gonna be... She's going to be in Vegas for a couple days when I get there, because I'm going to go to the Star Trek convention, and she's just not spent a lot of time in Vegas. So I was thinking about bringing in the SNES Classic. I've got... Shit, I shouldn't have done that. There we go. I've got Super Mario All-Stars, so we might repeat the experience and then call her friend at 4 o'clock in the morning. What's up, Kion? I died to the second enemy I saw in this game already. It was not pretty. It was not pretty. But hey, I made up for it. I'm getting mad lives now. And we're at the first castle. So let's see how I embarrass myself here. I had to leave Yoshi behind, and that's bullshit. Vegas is awesome. Are you kidding? I don't even gamble. Vegas is like the perfect place for me. It's like an adult Disneyland. Where food is available. Constantly. And I live in Minneapolis, so that's not really a thing for me. Like, places close here. So for me, the idea of food being available 24/7, just because I was hungry, is phenomenal. Also, I like arcades. I don't know, it's just... Vegas has got, like, an energy, and I do like large amounts of people as long as I'm not, like, in it. I like seeing them. Especially when they look kind of like me. See, Denny's, I got standards there. They're not high standards, but... Because, like, Smashburger was great. It hit the spot. I'm not a fan of walking on the strip. I definitely Ubered every chance I got, which I know drove my wife crazy. But when my friend and I get together, we're gonna get so drunk. It's gonna be amazing. There will be pictures. I might live stream some of it. I don't know. IRL streams are a thing, right? And you know what? Maybe I'll bring. I've got a little. We got this little bit, this that I just picked up, the AverMedia Live Gamer Portable 2. So maybe at that point, if I have a laptop, or if even if I don't, if I just record us playing and just embarrassing ourselves, that'd be fun to play later. I don't know. Yeah, Seal. Gonzo, let's do it. We could drunk stream something. That's not. I mean, I told you we wanted to do that drunk driving stream. So, shit, I needed that guy. No, Yoshi. Son of a bitch. I may be one of the better drunks I know. We probably could drink a liquor. Well, and that's the thing. I think what I'm figuring out is that top shelf liquor agrees with me. So I'm not a cheap date. So that's what heartbreak feels like. You're not the same Yoshi, but you'll do. I am not a lightweight. It takes me proper alcohol to get drunk. Damn it. Man, when I get drunk, I can stay drunk forever. It doesn't take... I can get maintenance drunk. Well, how am I the worst? How am I the worst? You son of a bitch. Nuganu, that's a hell of a deal. Whenever somebody's like, no, don't worry about it, I got your drinks tonight. I'm like, are you sure? Because, And then later it's like, oh man, I didn't know you were gonna drink $80. I'm like, don't worry, I got it. Sorry, I don't like Pilsner. What I always wanted. I've known too many Marines to assume that you wouldn't end up always naked at the end of every party. Yoshi, no! Oh, thank the gods. I know how Marines are. First guy who ends up passing out ends up naked. I think I just lost Yoshi forever. I did. did. Bye, friend. I'm the worst. Wow. Hyun, despite not weighing anything, apparently, is capable of holding his alcohol. And my best friend, one of my best friends, her name is Amy. Good Lord, she can drink me under the table. No. No! Why did I do this to myself? There we go. Oh, I see how that happened. Natural hot spring. If Kitty Kate ends up being available, I'm probably gonna get super drunk tonight. I'm not an alcoholic. I just really like drinking, and I don't require it to have fun, but it helps. All right, man, have a great stream. Catch you later. And by that, I mean I will stop by. Maybe when I'm drunk. Don't get lost! And then... Is that not... Is that how we do? Really? Really, I did that. I did that. So I don't know what I'm doing. Apparently I'm moving too fast. Or something. Something is going wrong. That's what I'm getting out of this. Oh no, cat. Not now. He's being such a little shit tonight, I don't want to reward him with, What am I missing here? Hmm. Turning it to Wumbo. I don't know what that means. I'm not really sure. I don't remember that going that way at all. But I don't know, my childhood is pretty long gone. I remember the first time I beat this game. We were in, what do they call that? Not the landlord, but like the super's apartment. She had kids that they had a Super Nintendo too, and we sat down one day and beat the game. I remember that. Cat is apologizing. I remember this little trick from Nintendo Power. Shout out to Nintendo Power. Y'all know what's up. I know there's some overachiever out there who gets 50s every time, but that's not mean, it's not fair. I know one of the things that people used to complain about with this game is that it's easy to fly over everything. I don't remember how to do the little floaty thing. There we go. There we go. Unfortunately. Tastes kind of like lime, and I don't like that. You know, I've never really like sat down and listened to this game in stereo. It's really, really pretty detailed. I think I really missed out on my childhood that way. TV. Hey Pitsy, thanks for the host. How you doing, man? trying to remember how to play these games. There we go. That's what everybody wanted. I remember something more important being up there. Oh, I'm doing all right. You know, got some SNES class going on here. Trying to remember what I'm doing is, I'm a little bit saddened by how badly my muscle memory has aged. So this is really interesting. In order to do that, like, sprite scaling effect, he actually is a background sprite. Because Mode 7 would only do background scaling. So, it was, you know, it's kind of cool that they came up with all these little tricks. This was the launch title for the game, for the system. That was a SNES claim to fame. Mode 7. And all these colors. We're doing all right. I haven't frosted the tips because I'm going to go all blonde. If that doesn't scare you, I don't know what will. Just a clusterfuck. I don't know what it is with you in the 90s, but I think you missed the decade. I don't think I'd look good in a perm. Although my mom would disagree. She was definitely for the perm. Damn, I missed. But yeah, we're gonna do an all blonde thing. Like a Japanese wrestler. About the blonde or the perm? Because I'm pretty sure she'd say no to the perm. No, I don't think she's really pro, God damn it. I don't think she's really pro blonde, but, you know, she'll let me experiment. I'm paying for it. It's not like, you know, borrowing money or whatever. I just thought it'd be done. Fun to do over the winter. And if I like it, I'll do it over the summer, too. In the summer wind. Oh, look at you, knowing the jazz standards. Sinatra is my personal favorite. I know it's kind of trite. Because Bing Crosby is pretty awesome, and I don't think he gets enough attention. But it was funnier, at least. To grab that, and I missed. Oh, the game definitely gave me the advantage on that one, and I did not deserve it. I'm the worst. Oh, come on. I'm so bad. Oh, man. Might have to switch games. This is getting embarrassing. The more I play these games, the more I realize that I have a very selective memory about the levels. Yep, one extra life. It's all I deserve. Maybe not even that. I deserve that one too, I guess. Shit, shit. I don't really know. I'm sure there's lore to all this, but I'm not familiar with any of it. Cool. I guess that was probably a room that recycles until you beat it. Yeah, you know, it's one of those... I wonder if that was an intentional thing or what the deal was, but it's one of those things where when you build the game, you have to do certain things, and what they were doing there was just recoloring the background. I don't know if they were capable of recoloring the foreground sprites as well. And they probably just looked at it and said, well, that's nifty enough. But who knows? I'm not angry at the game, I'm angry at me. Super Mario World remains one of those perfect games where the control is so good that if anything's gone wrong, it's your fault. I like these little blocks. I don't know if they show up in any other game, but I like them. Aw, here you go. That was worth it. I shall abandon you at the least inconvenient moment for you, my friend. Usually over a gap. Those are not the pipes you're looking for. Well, the thing is, I don't really remember anything anymore. And so, yeah, there might not be the pipes I'm looking for, but I really don't know what I'm looking for now. I vaguely remember this level. And it's not to say I haven't beaten this game. I've probably beaten it, I don't know, 10, 12 times? And not like, you know, I beat it and then walked away from, I mean, like, I 100%ed it maybe 10 or 12 times. I have a copy of the Super Mario World All-Stars plus Super Mario World game, which is not super rare, but not super popular. Were you a Genesis guy? Because that's usually how that turns out. And then those TurboGrafx-16 guys that we don't talk about. But anyway, I have that game, and I like all three of my saves are 100%ed. I actually have a physical copy of regular Super Mario World as well. That all three saves are 100%ed on. So, when I was younger, I loved this game. I legitimately don't remember this stage at all. No, no! Thank you. Yeah, I was definitely a SNES kid. I later got a Genesis because I wanted to see what I missed out on, but... The truth is... Having one or the other meant, like, you missed out on a console exclusive every 6 months or something. And while the Genesis did have the superior version of Aladdin, that's really not enough. I was never a Phantasy Star kid. I liked Final Fantasy. Genesis did, by far, have the superior version of Aladdin. However, the Super Nintendo Aladdin isn't shit just because of that. It's actually still a decent game. Nope. Mistakes were made. Not think about that. Oh, son of a bitch. Oh well. Okay, so let's talk about the X-Men game for a second, because I got problems with it. It was cool. Yeah, I dropped the P. Sorry, Pitsy, I know how particular you are about P's. The Genesis X-Men game was cool. And even with the tiny characters, because the SNES games had huge characters, like, it's nifty enough. Like, it was fun. All of the characters felt like there was a reason to play them beyond, hey, I just like Wolverine or Cyclops or whatever. There were actual advantages to playing them. So the game, by all merits, is good. Until you get to that situation in the room where you have to reset the computer. And I'll be goddamned, but I have never... in my life. Oh no. I dropped the P because I already ruined the door. And I did it again. Resetting the computer was bullshit because the game does not describe to you in the manner of which resetting the P is done. Resetting the computer is done. So, I didn't... Oof, that was close. I didn't know what I was doing. I don't think most people knew what they were doing. But you're supposed to reset the Genesis, right? So, I have a Genesis. I have the worst timing ever. So, I have a Genesis. I bought a Genesis. I bought a copy of X-Men, because I wanted to redo this, because I found out how you're supposed to do it, and I got to the point, and then you're supposed to reset the Genesis to reset the computer. What they don't tell you is you need to very lightly tap the button, and of course, I did not lightly tap the button. Ended up resetting the game entirely. And I did it two or three times. Couldn't figure out why it wasn't working. I went on GameFAQs. God damn it. I went on GameFAQs. It was explained that you're supposed to only lightly reset I had like a Genesis Model 2, and I guess on the Model 2 it's like a little more finicky to do it. Hey! I just, at that point, I was like, you know what? The Genesis X-Men game, as cool as it is, it's bullshit. That was crap. And then, like, if you're going to play it on an emulator, you can't actually, I guess it's pretty brilliant in that way. You can't play it on an emulator because you can't lightly reset the thing. Well, you know what? I thought the controller port 2 thing was pretty cool in Metal Gear. That said, the first time I beat Psycho Mantis, I didn't do the controller port thing. It's possible to beat that without doing the controller port thing. And I don't remember if there's different dialogue for that. But we are going to be playing Metal Gear. I don't know if we're going to do the original MSX games, but the Metal Gear Solid games at least, coming up. I might do a whole marathon. It might actually be like 24 hours of Metal Gear. Can I beat all 5 games in 24 hours? Fuck no. Sumo news. No, I can't say I would have kept up on sumo news regardless. No! I ran ahead without thinking. I'm not a legend. I just, like, it made sense. There were things in that game that were happening. And when you get to that fight, the first thing I did was crouch, like go prone. And it turns out he can't hit you with anything if you're prone. So that's how I did the entire fight. And it worked. But what's up with sumo news? Who's dead? So who is telling the truth? I thought there was supposed to be like great honor in competing in sumo. Sumo's starting to sound like American wrestling. Also, you say Yokozuna, and I think of Yokozuna, like, in the WWF. Think of the Japanese people to be so well behaved. I don't get sumo culture. But it's a thing. Too many Yokozunas. I'll never get over the time that Bret Hart dropped the title to Yokozuna and then immediately dropped the title to Hulk Hogan because Hulk Hogan's a piece of shit. And I was a Hulkamaniac as a kid. I feel regret about that. Damn it. Damn it. Yeah, I figured there are other nations that are probably pretty good at being fat. Well, that's a Yoshi thing. No, it's not all about being fat, but being, you know, using the fat to your advantage is a big thing about that. There's a reason weight classes exist. Why do I suck? Oh, he's got a little spike. He's got a little spike on his head. He's got a little. So yeah, you know, they've got a Genesis Classic-esque machine that I kind of thought about buying at some point, but it turns out it sucks. So instead, I'm gonna have to just hook up my regular Genesis. And who knows, maybe if I actually hook up a Genesis, I might revisit X-Men and we can have another shit chat about the reset button thing after I fuck it up. Worst bonus stage ever. I walked into that. Why did I walk into that? Just don't have the timing. I'm terrible. Just cranking through this game. Thought it was gonna take a little bit longer. I don't know if you've ever seen the speed run of this game. There's a speed run of this game where they actually reprogram the variables by doing some certain sequence of events. God damn it. It's pretty nifty shit. It takes like 3 minutes. I think I've seen it done in like 45 seconds. Maybe less. It's endlessly impressive to me that people figure those things out. I thought it was so clever. It was not clever. It was like eating, like they have to collect Yoshi and they have to eat berries and then if they, while they're holding something in their mouth, they got to kill an enemy while stomping on another enemy or something, I don't know, something really fucking confusing. Whatever it is, it's fucking amazing. Like, there was some guy who figured this out. He was looking at the hex variables and went, you know what? If I do these six things, this variable becomes that, and then all I have to do is, and that'll let me reprogram the game so I can see the ending. And you're like, Jesus. Bye. thought it'd be that'd be the one. Yep, working on it. Ludwig von Cooper. I actually do remember the look of this level. I think I remember when I was a kid, I used to just fly over it. Because I'm a cheap ass. And I'm an idiot. Jesus, I can't stop bouncing off of everything. If I jump over here. Yep. Yep, it's gone. How could this happen to me? That's not what I wanted. That'll work. Come on, Mario, you can make it. Just have to wait for him to deflate. Too much pasta, you know. No. Why am I so bad at this? I think I need to start drinking. I think that might be the problem. It's not a crutch, it's an assist. Ah, Tanuganu, you're not bad at everything. You're actually pretty fucking good at Pokemon. I was watching for a while the other night. Color me fucking impressed, because you got out of some really shit situations in the randomizer. That was bullshit. That was bullshit. Well, at least I fit down here now. I think it was gray. Was it gray? Does it sound right? I don't know. It was like 3 or 4 days ago. Not Wednesday. Maybe Monday night. I can't remember. But you were gonna die because of a fucking Magikarp or something? I don't remember. There was some really bullshit situation you got into where the game spawned like a dude who was like 12 levels above your Pokemon. He wiped like 3 of them out. It was pretty bad. And you managed to survive. Yeah, maybe Diamond. It's a trap. Okay, so, no, Ash Gray, that was the one, yeah. Pitsy, I read that completely wrong. Wow. You can't just say stuff like that. I'm gonna have a heart attack. Actually, I'm fine. You dick. I think you know exactly what I saw. I think you know what I saw. Culinary people are weird, but you're up. Your cumin burps are. That's next level. Force that on me. Like Pitsy with his cum burps. This game is having no mercy with me. It's supposed to be easy. That's why I'm playing it. I don't ever get to play easy games. Probably should take that. I'm worried about your process. You can't blow your way through, culinary school. I'm going to use all my lives here. That's what's going to happen. Thankfully, I bought some cold brew coffee to mix with my Patron XL. XL Cafe. What the fuck just happened there? Oh, game. Come on. You know, my ex-wife's best friend went to culinary school, and she ended up not getting a job cooking as much as she loved cooking. She ended up getting a job doing flavor processing, whatever. I swear there was an upstairs there. I swear. I'm not crazy, am I? Well, I mean, probably, but. We'll just carry this for a little while. No. She was a lovely person. I wouldn't say anything particularly bad about her. Or my ex-wife. I mean, I don't like my ex-wife, but... But she's a lovely human being, and I hope that wherever she is, whatever she's doing, that she is happy. And I hope I never see her again. No, but I don't want to say she blew her way through culinary school. That's not fair. It's like saying you don't have any merits and you don't deserve anything you've gotten. Oh, this is one of those spots where I think you can, like, speedrunners always do, like, a trick to get through. Grab it. No, you don't know my ex-wife. She was very shy anyway. Had we met, I'm sure she'd have been very interested in your culinary pursuits, but she was never really up for meeting new people, especially people I knew. No, actually, let's think. We got him in 2008? Maybe 2009? So, they've probably got a couple years yet. They're not purebred Chihuahuas, but they're... Chihuahuas themselves are supposed to live anywhere between 12 and 18 years, which I thought was ridiculous. We got them as a birthday gift for me, despite my not wanting Chihuahuas. Or dogs. I didn't want dogs. Because I wanted to travel. And you can't get anybody to watch your dogs. It's not like a baby where you can guilt trip your parents or whatever. Yeah. We got married in 2007. Oh. Fuck you, fish. We can never get anybody to watch our dogs. Shit. That was a mistake. That was a mistake. Yeah, she said, "Hey, do you want to get dogs?" And I said, "No." And then, like, a month later, she was like, "Hey, do you want dogs?" And I said, "No." And then she said, "Hey, so my aunt has got two dogs that she needs to get rid of, and I would like to get dogs." And then I said, "Fine." And she said, "Great, we can call them a birthday present for you." And I was like, "I'm not really sure how that works out." Because I was very anti-dogs. And they're cute. I like them. I was never particularly attached to them. It was great to nap with dogs because they were very warm and they like to sleep in the warmer parts of your body. So, fuck me. So it was always a comfortable nap. And I do love napping. God damn it. It's the only thing that's gone right so far. I say. So when we got divorced, she looked at me and said, "So we're gonna have to fight about the dogs?" And I said, "No, you can have them." And then that was the end of it. I'm not crazy. That stage does move vertically from there. And now it doesn't. Now it doesn't. Now it doesn't. Can I restart the stage proper? Nope. We're gonna start another stage. I'm stupid. What does that have to do with dogs? Unless by oxtail you mean you were gonna take dog. To which I say, sir. Put myself in a bit of a pickle here, didn't I? Did I say oxtail? I meant tongue. Still, dogs are not exchangeable. We'll see if it reset that other stage. It did not. That's very interesting to know. Although it did seem to reset the verticality of the stage, so that's kind of interesting too. Although it did not change anything for the stage itself, so that was a waste of my time. Learning lessons. That's just a great sound effect. You know exactly what you're getting with that one. Bomb. Oh, I'd watch the Super Mario Brothers movie on stream if I could. That's one of those experiences that should be shared amongst friends. All right, Tsunugunu, good luck in your run. You're gonna do fine. Probably better than I'm doing. I'm one of those really awful classic game purists where I'm sitting here thinking, you know, I'm doing this badly, maybe I should reset and start all over again. No, Yoshi, no! Ha! You can stop him from popping on that bike. Yeah, that's cool. I didn't know that. I think they look particularly similar. Similar. Because the feather that drops is like super thin. Damn it. Come here. Come to me. Human burps. That went so badly. My back. That was my back. Well, so far it doesn't look like we're dropping any frames. Does, however, look like I don't know where the fuck I'm going. Truth is, I don't know where the fuck I'm going. I don't know if you ever watched the Super Mario World cartoon growing up. I think it was a piece of shit. I mean, as much as the Super Mario World Super Show sucked, at least that was funny. He just ate that staircase. Whatever. He ate the thing. Can't be healthy. Ooh, that was close. All right, Pitsy, thanks for stopping by. Appreciate it. Hope you have a better day than that. Nope, that's gone. Okay, now I'm officially lost. So I'm gonna grab a drink. Anybody still there? I'm gonna go get a drink.
Quiz cue,
Yeah. Wanna be one of the greatest. Your boy got a long way to go. But what's on your mind, nigga, say? Said I'm hearing it all except no. Nah, I don't wanna stop till I'm winning. Nah, I don't wanna quit cause they dissing. People hate when it's different and can't accept change. I just change my attention. I'm switching the lane, getting chips and I'm dipping. Saucing, saucing, dusting that bullshit off. You're off for something else to get it popping. Whoa, never fall cause I'm on the road. I ain't trying to be one of those. Niggas saying what it could have been. I'ma live it how I should have been. Wanna pull up in a murder Benz. All black to the fucking tin. T-Pain, all I do is win. Triple that no matter what. Negatives ain't adding up. Hey, yo, make sense, nigga, add it up. Full tank won't gas you up. Hella hits, nigga, batter up. Want the cake and stir the batter up. Keep the show and bring the cash to us. You can be the kind of like a leg. I'm the butter to the fucking bread. Don't cooperate with not a fed. Look, I ain't hear a single word you said. Y'all sleep, better shake the bed. Wash your feet till a nigga fed. Hey, fuck it, keep going.
Add the words of the blood burning shit.
Yeah. Yeah. It's just a warm up, no call. Better warm up, cause shit getting cold. Gone, bro, not again. Never that, no offense. Fuck a fence, hit a wall. Let them in, cause we all got a ball. Not a problem with it, if they got it, I swear I'ma get it, just give me a call. Hit my line, if it's false, then you lost. I do not take those. But y'all niggas fry like potatoes. And the fuck should go that way, no Quavo. And I know I'ma pop like an Ego. And the 50 same color as mayo. And the flow gotta stay at the mail. When I post on the man with the mail. With the men in the
mirror. Oh, I love scotch. Oh, it's so good. Oh, I love scotch. So I have no idea where I am or where I'm going in my life. I feel like this is the crux of it. You dick. All right, Kion, have a nice night. Thanks for stopping by. Oh, I'm just gonna change games because I suck. Thank you. was better than nothing, I guess. I'll take it. Take it on the run, baby. So that's the normal way to go. We ghost house, and then comes all the way back. So there must be another issue. Like, we got to get out of this one correctly, right? That's what it is. Because I went through the secret, and that's how we got to... You have to be the key. Yoshi, it has to be you. It had to be you. It had to be you. Nobody else gave me a thrill. This is a nice way to earn extra lives. Ah, this is what it is. I still don't know how you're supposed to get out of this normally. Maybe that is the normal exit. Yeah, it's gotta be the normal exit. Kind of? Where the fuck is that other castle? Whatever, it's not important now. What's going on, Monkey Farts? Yeah, we're playing Super Mario Bros. 1, and I suck Super Mario World 1. Super Mario World 1. It's pretty bad, actually. I can make no excuses. I used to know this game backwards. It's not like Super Mario World 2, where, you know, I've only beaten it twice ever. And one of them I was really drunk for. I should know this game backward and forward, and I don't remember anything. Thank you. I bet you can. I bet you can. There's a muscle memory that comes with speed running, and once you get it back, it's probably there. Although I got Mega Man X, I should play that again. The last time I beat Mega Man X was on the port that they made for the PSP. If you remember that. It's not well revered. No, there was like an actual Mega Man X port that they made for the PSP. I don't remember what it's called. It was like Maverick Hunter X. Yeah, it was Mega Man Maverick Hunter X, I think. And it was super easy. Legit don't have the patience for this anymore. The guy even went back and got all the upgrades so you could do the, was it the Dragon Punch? Is that what you get? I can't remember. One of them has a Dragon Punch, the other one has the Hadouken. I can't believe I just did that. I can't believe... Because I think it was the Dragon Punch in the first game, and then the Hadouken in the second game, because the Hadouken lets you just like cruise through the game. Not that the Dragon Punch was much better. Oh, okay, well, what do I know? I remember the upgrades being way easier to find in the Mega Man X versus X2. I think I beat X2. I don't think I ever beat X3. And I don't think I ever beat X4. See, it bounced off last time. I'm not stupid. I'm stupid. I take it back. I should stick to first-person shooters. And I should learn how to divide my attention between my chat and the game. Definitely been my downfall here. Every time I see it reset, I think to myself, oh, I gotta look. And I think it refreshes every 30 seconds. Oh my god. Oh my god. Oh my god. This isn't even that hard. I don't know what the problem is. At this point, I feel like I'd be more likely to beat Battletoads. Thank the gods. Ooh, I got stuck in that statue, and I'm not gonna get that one up. That's fine. You gotta be shitting me. Oh, we did that at least. Or a survey, because I'm in the middle of a study. They're going to be very disappointed that I never go out, because I don't have friends. I feel a little distressed. I'm mildly upset. I'm not inspired. I would say I'm moderately determined. Not scared. Not nervous. A little excited. Moderately enthusiastic, moderately alert, not afraid at all. I'm a little anxious. No tobacco. I did get 14 hours of sleep yesterday. You know, they're probably going to turn back and say, you know what? I think you're depressed. I did not consume any alcoholic beverages yesterday. I am not at all reserved, and I would say I'm a little trusting, kind of lazy, very relaxed. I have some artistic interests. I would say that I am outgoing. I do find fault with others. I do a thorough job. I don't really get nervous. I do have an active imagination. Isn't this interesting? Survey completed. Look at that. Oh, look at you. Can't eat you. Oh! Oh, that's even cuter. I forgot about you guys entirely. I didn't even know you were in the game. I'm a little bit worried about the big ones being able to close their pupils. That's kind of weird, but I guess we'll let it go. Nope. That's okay. We don't need it. Really? Yoshi, come back. I've been a fool for you. Need to get some new one-ups. That one. There's no better way to do this than on top of a Yoshi. Small when you That's really cute. Good goddamn. I cannot tell you how many of these situations I keep getting myself into. Yoshi, what's up? Yoshi, what's up? Okay, let's try this again. Although I'm pretty sure I have to abandon you. Fuck me. I need a Yoshi. Do I? Maybe I should skip the pipe. I'm gonna skip the pipe. Skip the pipe. Nope, can't skip the pipe. So bad. I'm really bad. And I don't know what to do at this point. I'm stuck. Some laundry. Come on, dolphins, don't lead me astray. Oh shit. I almost didn't make it. I almost didn't make it. That was bad. Thank you. Come on. I added a get good scrub button for myself. I need it. I should be using it. Hoping I'd be able to make it through this save and go with another game, because I'm frustrated with myself endlessly. Although it looks like I might just die. What I should do is own this game and fucking speedrun it. I'm embarrassed. Why did I even jump over him? Why? Like, it wasn't even a logical decision. That I know what happened there. Hi, Kitty Kate. How are you? I suck. I don't even have an excuse for sucking. I know this game back. Well, I used to know this game backwards and forwards. Apparently, I've lost all of that. It's gone. A part of me is gone. I know, I can't even say what's killing me here, because it's not logical. Although, newer games are definitely harder than older, are easier than older games, but, I'm just awful. Newer games are definitely easier than older games. But this one was supposed to be easy. Like, that's... I just thought I'd rip through it real quick. And we did fine for the first, I don't know, 4 worlds, but then... Whew, I should have known. my hubris. Well, I mean, the last time I saved was 2 levels ago. I think what I need to do is actually be Big Mario and then bounce off of him to get up there. But I'm not. If this is any indication, it's going to take me like 140 lives to beat Legend of Zelda: Link to the Past. Current mood. Ghost. Nope, that didn't work at all. I had a dream about this moment. Oh no. I've dreamt about this moment. This is like extreme deja vu. Extreme deja vu. Anyway, Kate, you're alive. How are you? You feel like shit? Okay. Sorry to hear that. Oh, you wait. Yeah, I did that on Thursday night. Holy shit. I've given up, apparently. I'm just going to jump directly into pits and, you're happy. Because in case it wasn't clear, I suck. You should rescue me. Do you have any ambition to play Battlegrounds tonight? I don't know why. See, like, at this point, I don't even know why I wasn't ready for that. I should have been ready for that. Oh, okay. Well, I guess we're just doing this all night then. I was actually going to switch games because I'm getting kind of bored of making the same mistakes over and over again. I legit don't know what I'm doing. Me happy. There's a lot of things that make me happy right now. Pizza's on that list. Not running out of lives would be on that list too. Oh. Yeah, like pizza. I don't know what I'm supposed to do here. I'm legit lost. Oh yeah, if you want to offer help, please do. That's absolutely. I think I mentioned that at some point. My channel. I'll go back. It's fine. It's fine. I'll take help. I'm always willing to take help. Oh no. Apparently, by saving, you lose all the lives you had before. So it didn't matter where or when I saved. Good to know. I'll get back. We have to sacrifice the Yoshi to do it, but we'll get back. Well, I missed that entirely. It's a good thing I missed that thing. I don't mind dying a million times. I'm just like, I'm frustrated by my skill set here. Like if the reason I'm dying is because the game is difficult, I'm totally fine with that. But apparently I just suck. And that's frustrating to me. I've met my match, and it's Super Mario World, a game I've beaten thousands of times in my childhood. Maybe not thousands, probably like 20, but like 100%ed a dozen times. and that's what's defeating me today. Yeah, well, unfortunately, I can't say I'm even getting stuck on the secret Star World levels because I haven't found the entrances yet. I don't even deserve to speak. No, it's not hard. I suck. That's let's be clear. It's not that the game is any harder. The game is, I'm sure, just as easy as we all remember. I just suck. Yeah, I saw the half in the bag was posted. I haven't watched it yet. I kind of want to just see the movie. The critics hate it. All of the fans that I know, like DC fans, all seem to have enjoyed it. So I kind of want to just watch it. So I'm thinking about doing that in the next couple days. Wife isn't interested in going, so. So I gotta do it by myself. Which is always difficult to do because I have no motivation to go out by myself. And then the rest of my friends talk during movies because they're horrible, horrible people. If you're a movie talker. Yep, I sacrificed him. Oh, God. See, I don't like going by myself. I like to discuss movies with people afterwards. I like to talk about what I liked, what I didn't like, and what I would have done differently were I in charge of directing a movie. Like, what was the name of that movie? Ender's Game. One of my favorite books ever. And I hated the movie, and I'm glad I got to see it with somebody who was, by the way, very silent. Because then I got to discuss it with somebody afterwards, and talk about what I would have done differently. And she always get driven crazy by, like, she would call it backseating. Alright. Kate. Now's your time to shine. I'm gonna have another drink. The ghost blocks. Oh, see. You're so smart. Oh, they're gone. So I gotta grab the other ones, I guess. I'm too stupid to have figured this out on my own. I'm not drunk enough to have not figured that out on my own. I don't have an excuse. I'm just bad. Actually, you know what? Crying babies don't bother me. What the fuck are you doing? I don't ever see PG-13 movies ever. So thank you for your help. I don't see 13. I really don't see PG-13 movies. I like to see rated R movies. I like to support the rated R economy. So it absolutely drives me crazy that people bring, like, babies to rated R movies. I lost all of my power-ups in one shot. This is how bad I am. You know what? I can't. All right, Kate, that's one way of looking at it. Maybe, like, you know, when you made the decision to become a parent, you made the decision to forego all of the things that normal people get to do. And the part of the trade-off of that is that when you are no longer able to go see a movie, and you're no longer able to take a legit vacation, and you're no longer able to go to the restaurant, that's the trade-off for you being a complete asshole on Facebook and saying, oh, you just graduated college and it was really tough. You know what's really tough? Parenthood. Fuck you. If you want to do that shit, you don't get to do normal things. And if you don't do that shit, if you're one of those people who are like, oh, I never do that, and you legit never do that, I'll watch your kid while you go see a movie. I'll go watch your kid while you go have a nice meal. But if not, if you're one of those people who are like, well, you know what's really hard? Parenthood. Fuck you, and you never deserve to enjoy anything again. Man, I thought life was pretty hard, but then I became a mom. Yeah, fuck you. Fuck all of you. I've got some really intense thoughts about mommy jacking. I got mommy jacked by somebody the other day. Like, somebody I knew who said, like, oh yeah, well, it's not really hard until you have kids. And I said, did you just fucking mommy jack me? And they were like, oh, God, no, I didn't mean to. I can't believe I just did that. And yeah, you know what? You did. You know who you are. Yeah, seriously, they know who they are. I appreciate that they are very likely to watch this on YouTube later, but I have not forgotten your transgression, and I will make you pay. I've got a friend who's been really cool. He's been a very good friend of mine, and they're having a baby. He and his wife are having a baby in like 2 weeks. And really excited for him because he's been really excited about being a parent. And his wife is like, they've been together for like 15 years and he's younger than I am. Yeah, that look. He's younger than I am and he's been really excited about the prospect of having kids. But I swear to the God, if he does that mommy jacking shit to me, I'm gonna disown him. Hey, sweetheart, how are you? My wife is home. Yeah, they've been dating since high school. Like, they have been through some shit together, you know? Like, if they were gonna break up, it would have happened a long time ago. They waited until they've wanted to have kids for a long time. You know, not the entirety of it. They really wanted to enjoy, like, having a marriage together. But they didn't want to have kids until they had a house. So they waited until they could afford a house. And now that they can finally, like, say that they've crossed that off their to-do list, they're now having kids. So, like, good for them for holding out for what they wanted. And I have no doubt that he's going to be a great parent. That's not what I wanted to do. That's what I did last time. And that did not change anything. Yeah. Man, I mean, everybody knows because everybody had a high school sweetheart, right? Well, there's nothing wrong with being a late bloomer. I think you missed out on the worst parts of humanity. Because Lord knows that there is nothing worse than a teenager, male or female. They're all awful, awful human beings. My dad and I don't get along, but if there's one thing I'm very sorry about, it's about him having to deal with me as a teenager. I don't remember this game being this complicated. I thought you used to be able to beat this game without the secret entrances and shit. Did this change? Am I wrong? Was I just so much better at this when I was a kid? Fuck it. Fuck it. I forgot that the turtle was there. I don't know how you can watch this and be having fun, but then get infuriated because I die in Cuphead. Because I'm infuriated right now. I could die 1,000 times in Cuphead, it wouldn't bother me. But feeling like I don't know what my childhood comprised of is actually really frustrating. Well, apparently they know my struggle. They knew I was coming. I don't remember any of this shit. Let's see, I'm thinking back to my first, like, legit girlfriend. I think her name was Allison. I think it was, like, 12? Emily, who was the smallest woman I'd ever met. She wasn't a woman. She was like 4'8 when I was already pretty tiny. I bet she's still probably very short. Well then. You know, before that, there was always girls you flirt with. Like, you have elementary or middle school crushes. Thank you. Damn it. I bounced off the platform. It's not where I wanted to end up. Wow, okay, wow. Come on. Swear to the gods. I swear to the gods. How did you end up over here? What the fuck? Hi, honey. How was your day? I found out that Tiny's been opening the cabinet not just to fuck around with it. He's been sitting in it.
So? What's wrong with him sitting in it?
Well, like, he gets behind the foodstuffs and sits in it. Yeah.
You fucking weirdo.
And, he antagonized Dean earlier, and when Dean chased him, he jumped in there.
Dean jumped in there?
No. He was hiding from Dean.
Thank you.
No. This has gone very badly. I used to know this game. Yeah, Jackie just got back from work. I swear you like her better than you like me. Kate says hi. Says hi in case you didn't hear that. I'm sure you did. There's nothing good up there. That was all a trick. Oh my God. It's not even, it's terrible. Absolutely terrible. Fuck. Got got a little overconfident, I guess. No. No! Fuck. I don't know what it is, but I have just the incredible capability of losing everything. Everything. All that is good in my life is gone. All that is good in my game life is gone. I mean, those are good for nothing. They're good for nothing. Smort. Thank fuck. How about that airplane, huh? Better be nice to be on an airplane right now. I actually don't like flying. Thank you. You must be new to this channel because dying is kind of my thing. In fact, I was thinking about having dying patented so that I can trademark it and sue anybody who does it on Twitch. Fuck. I don't know why I didn't learn from that last time. Like, oh my God. I might actually be more relaxed if I was playing Ghosts and Goblins or Ghouls and Ghosts, because I beat that 2 years ago on professional. I told myself I'd never play it again. I mean, what we should be doing is playing PUBG. If you're up for it. Shout out to Mario's lung capacity. Unfortunately, it's reduced for Mario 64. Completely forgot about that. Oh, no me gusta. No me gusta. Thank you. I don't remember this at all. I don't remember that ending. Because it was only one stage. Yeah, I remember some of it, but I don't remember the ending of that at all. I'm pissed off because I could swear I was kicking that, but apparently I wasn't kicking that. Mole in a hole. Mole in a hole. Well, it's not ironic. It's because he's blind. Like I'm blind. That was like a frame difference. Yeah, or Stevie Wonder. Take your pick. Maybe like Diet Coke, I don't know. Do we have to ride on that guy? Yeah, I do. Hey, I needed that. Just shoot me. So much more confident when I had a block. Oh, that was painful. That was actually physically painful. Son of a bitch. Why did I do that to myself? I'm never gonna get out of this stage. Thank the gods. that backwards. Did that backwards. Don't have a Yoshi. Why didn't I learn from that? I don't know. Fuck it, we're finishing it tonight. Not like anybody's ever had a challenge with this before. No one in the history of Twitch has ever been like, you know what? We're gonna finish this really difficult game. Super Mario World. Not as sad as I sound in my heart. That was, but it sounded big. I don't know anything about sports. Lionheart Tilly, welcome to the crew. Thanks for the follow. Hope you're doing well. I'm not doing well. This is going very poorly. I cannot believe this. I can believe this. This is actually well within my capabilities to be terrible at this game. Appreciate it. I should be more drunk than this, honestly. And I shouldn't have done that. I knew better than that, and I did that anyway, because fucking stupid. You know what sounds fun right now is Final Fantasy VI. I might actually switch to that because... I have no words. More than just music, that's like the game that my heart sings for. I love that game. Yeesh. Hey, we made it. Thank the gods. Feel my spine compressing out of that. Hey, that was just lucky. I'll take it. I'll take it. I'm not too proud to take luck. Okay. What do you think of the last time I beat Final Fantasy VI? It was like, PlayStation collection came out. first. Ooh, that was close. Okay. Fuck up, don't fuck up, don't fuck up, don't fuck up. Oh. Shit. Well, at least we made it. I'll take that. We didn't make it far, though. Fuck me. Ugh. Yoshi, please save me. Take it back. I have no idea how my friend and I would beat Super Mario Brothers. There's no way. Fuck. I don't know why I'm incapable of playing this game. I don't know why. Something. Oh, Yoshi, come back. God, fuck me. Oh. Need a drink.
Quiz Cube, where that be?
Yeah.
yeah, wanna be one of the greatest. Your boy got a long way to go. But what's on your mind, nigga, say? Said I'm hearing it all except no. Nah, I don't wanna stop till I'm winning. Nah, I don't wanna quit cause they dissing. People hate when it's different and can't accept change. I just change my attention. I'm switching the lane, getting chips and I'm dipping sauce and sauce. And dusting that bullshit off. You're off for something else to get it popping. Whoa, never fall cause I'm on the road. I ain't trying to be one of those. Niggas saying what it could have been. I'ma live it how it should have been. Wanna pull up in a murder bin. All black to the fucking tin. T-Pain, all I do is win. Triple that no matter what. Negatives ain't adding up. Hey, yeah, makes sense, nigga, add it up. Full tank won't gas you up. Hella hits, nigga, batter up. Want the cake and start a batter up. Hit the show and bring the cash to us. You can be the kind of like a legend. I'm the butter to the fucking bread. Don't cooperate with not a fed. Look, I ain't hear a single word you said. Y'all sleep, better shake the bed. Watch your feet till a nigga fed. Fuck it, keep going.
The words of the blood dirty shit.
Yeah, 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 yeah. Yeah. It's just a warm-up, no call. Better warm-up, cause shit getting cold. Gone, bro, not again. Never that, no offense. Fuck a fence, hit a wall. Let them in, cause we all got a ball. Not a problem with it, if they got it, I swear I'ma get it, just give me a call. Hit my line, if it's false, feel you lost. I do not take those. But y'all niggas fry like potatoes. And the fuck should go that way, no Quavo. And I know I'ma pop like an Ayo. And the 50 cent color is mayo. And the flow gotta stay at the mayo. When I post on the man with the mail. Fuck with the men in the mirror. Look, I understand this shit clear, you don't. Y'all doing nothing except for the most. I got the edge on you, I like the coast. I'm about to take it as far as it goes. Far as you want, whole society immortal. Never worried, I'm immortal. If you see me, keep it cordial. Fresh and walking through a portal. Guess I'm in a new dimension. The top, do it for the vision. Fuckin' we in this bitch, yeah, yeah. I'm living, I can't be a failure. Tell them I've been trying to tell you.
Came back with my special concoction. It's one part Patron Exo Cafe, one part cold press coffee. Tastes disgusting. heck I even beat this before. And you know, this is actually one of those times where I like to reiterate something I tell people. I'm not good at games. I'm terrible. Just persistent. Which drives me crazy because I used to be good at this one. Distracted. And actually, at this point, I'm not even having fun. So, let's do the switch. I don't know what to call it. I actually remember hating the beginning of this game. Which is always the way it is. There's always like a sequence where you hate something in every game. Metal Gear Solid 2, Metal Gear Solid, Metal Gear Solid 3 all had sequences like that. Metal Gear Solid 4 had sequences like that. Just, you don't want to play through that bit. So you always have to think, I'm going to want to sit through that part. And this is it. It's the beginning of this game. I think this might be a direct rip of the SNES game. Doesn't look like it's been retranslated. You know what? We're going to roll with the credits for a minute.